بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Prophet Uzair alayhi salam is one of the prophets who was sent to Bani Israel. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent so many prophets and messengers to Bani Israel, but they did not appreciate that blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Uzair alayhi salam came after Musa alayhi salam. And he followed the teachings of Musa alayhi salam, and he followed Torah, and he was very wise man, and he was very pious. During the time of Prophet Uzair alayhi salam, the people of Bani Israel neglected the Torah. They did not teach the Torah, they did not learn the Torah. So nobody knows about Torah. Only man who knows about the Torah was Prophet Uzair alayhi salam. And Prophet Uzair alayhi salam memorized the Torah. One day, during his journey, Prophet Uzair alayhi salam went past a village.
So Prophet Uzair went past this village, and that village is to belong to the people and the children of Israel. And that village has been destroyed. It's been destroyed, it's been cut down, its trees, the houses of that village have been destroyed and demolished. He had with him his donkey, and he had some food. Some of the scholars say it was a bunch of grapes and a bit of bread. So he sat nearby that village, looking at that village from far, so amazed, so shocked to see to the state of that village and the condition of that village.
And he asked a question, how is Allah going to resurrect this? Not in that he was defying, but he was inquisitive. He wanted to know, how will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrect this, and how will he bring it back to life?
So he ate some of the grapes they had and ate some of that bread they had, and then he rested under the tree. Allah Azza wa Jal wanted a miracle to appear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Uzair sleep for 100 years. He slept for one full century. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala resurrected him. Allah Azza wa Jal brought him back to life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to him an angel, in which this angel will ask him, and obviously the angel came in the appearance of a human being. He said to him, how long did you sleep for? Uzair did not even think that he slept for 100 years. He said, I slept maybe a day or half a day. So this angel will say to him, you slept for 100 years. You didn't sleep one day, you didn't sleep half a day, but you slept for 100 years. That was a shock to Uzair alayhi salam. And then he says to him,
take a look at your food and your drink. It has not yet become stale. It's as fresh as it was. But we want to show you something else. So he takes a look at his drink and his food. It's very fresh, as it was the day he went off.
But his donkey, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made his donkey die. And not only that, his donkey turned into dust. So Allah wanted to show him the miracle, how Allah revives the dead.
Allah says, now look at the donkey on the other side. Look at it. It's only bones. Watch how we will bring it back to life. And he's watching. And Allah says, look at how we put the bones all coming together. The bones began to come together. And look at how we've clothed it with flesh. And it's clothed with flesh once again. That's his donkey once again. When he saw this clearly, he says, I declare and I know sound knowledge. I have now seen with my eye. Allah is definitely able and capable to do anything. Nothing is impossible for Allah. Everything that people call impossible, in the eyes of Allah, it is simple and straightforward. Very easy. So there's nothing impossible for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
He went back to that village and he saw that village once again vibrant and alive. People are living in that village. People had settled in that village. People have houses in that village. People have farms around that village. There is the market. There is people there. The village is so vibrant and alive. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered Uzair alayhi salam when he says, how could Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revive this dead village after it's dead? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revived it, and Allah azza wa jal showed Uzair how Allah brings the dead back alive, whether to be a human being or even an animal. Not only that, even when there's a dead village, Allah azza wa jal revived it.
Now the same man, he went back, this Uzair, he went back And his people were now in doubt. Who is this man? They had all passed away. There was a new generation. Besides a few, the young were still alive, but many of them did not recognize him. They didn't know who he was. His own children did not recognize him initially. There was one old lady beyond 100 years old. It is reported 120. They asked her, "Do you know this man known as Uzair?" She says, "Yes. He was a pious man, saintly man, so on and so forth. And all the du'as he made were accepted." But she was blind. They brought him in front. She couldn't see. She says, "But wait, if he is the same Uzair, he was mustajabud da'wah. Every du'a he made was accepted. So tell him to make a du'a that my eyesight is restored." So Uzair makes a du'a. "May the eyesight of this woman be restored." It was restored by the gift of Allah subhanahu. When it was restored, she looks at him and she says, "Indeed, this is the man. This is the same Uzair." When they went to the children said, "There is a mark from which we will recognize our father. He had a mark on his body somewhere." And they recognized him and said, "Indeed, this is the man." Now he became a hit, subhanallah. The Jewish people started saying, "This is the son of God." They started saying, "He is the son of God." Allah says in the Quran, the Jewish people, on one hand, they were saying Uzair is the son of Allah, and the Christians are saying that Jesus is the son of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. Now, we see why they say that he was the son of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, na'udhu billah, may Allah safeguard us. What a great blasphemy, because of a few miracles that occurred on his hands. And this is also a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
And then the people and the children of Israel surrounded Uzair. They loved Uzair so much. They respected Uzair so much. And Uzair revived. Uzair revived the Torah amongst the children of Israel at that time. And he was the reviver. He was the reviver of the Torah and the teachings of Musa, the religion of Islam, amongst the people and the children of Israel at that time. They loved him so much, they were attached to him so much, that they ever exaggerated in Uzair. And the Jews said that Uzair is the son of Allah, but Uzair is the prophet and the messenger of Allah.
And alayhi salam, Uzair passed away, and then later on after him, it was Zakaria alayhi salam to come to Bani Israel.
Inshallah, we have an appointment with that. Until we meet again, wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad, subhanallah bihamdih, subhanakallahumma bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.